Hey guys, it's Drew here at Card of My Eye, and you just saw the beginning of my new videos. All of them have that new introduction, and I really like it. And then the little image of me, my little cartoon image, as well as the Drew Michael designs, is the new signature on my blog. So if you go to my blog and underneath all of my posts, that's my new signature. But I wanted to show you yet another mini album I created, and this one I finished last night, the Christmas one I showed. About a couple hours ago, I made two nights ago and finished it last night as well. But this one is up on eBay as well. I just posted it literally 5 minutes ago, but it'll be posted like an hour ago when you guys go check it out because this video is going to be uploaded in about an hour. But it's titled Family Traditions, and it's more of a vintage mini album, you guys. So it's more my style mini album. And the reason why I'm not doing like all these pull-up pockets, tags, and everything is it's way too hard to take pictures of all of this stuff. And so, let's start off. First, what it is a paper bag mini album. And I love paper bag albums, and this is my version of a paper bag album. I'll probably do a tutorial on it in the future, but it's a really simple album. I'll show you how to do it. Like right now, without even using paper bags. But I bound it with 3 gold binding rings. 1-inch sturdy binding rings, and I added some ribbons and fibers on the edges, some glimmer misted laces, and I added a Tim Holtz swivel clasp with a Muse token that says Journey, or I think that's a Muse token. Nancy could probably tell me, she knows everything about Tim, or a little bird. So, and then the paper collection is a Times Nouveau paper by Graphic 45. It's a really nice collection, and I stitched this square photo mat, and I distressed and inked it, and I also distitched this, well, actually, I did not stitch that, but I inked it and added it on some patterned paper, and there's just lots of different layers. Sorry about that, guys. And it says Family Traditions, and I printed that out on my computer on some basic gray white cardstock. And then I ran some of the flatback pearls that I got from Nancy down at the bottom. And I added on some I Am Roses flowers. I added on this I Am Roses leaf, and I curled a little stem that I learned that from Arlene. Thanks so much, Arlene, for that tip. And then I added on some I Am Roses. This is the Recollections here. And then I Am Roses, I Am Roses, I Am Roses, I Am Roses, and I Am Roses. All their different gardenias and roses across there. And so that's the front cover. The first page, again, you guys, I like to add large photo mats for people to add their pictures to, and just a couple embellishments and some ribbon that they can slip their photos under. And again, all of the photo mats are sewn, so if you can see, this one has a zigzag stitch across it. You probably can't see that, but it does. And I added on some grosgrain ribbon and a couple Prima flowers, as well as the hip to jive little tag that came in the collection, and I added on some kind of string so it looks like it's a little hanging sign. And what I do to the mini album, how I create it is I take a paper bag, fold it in half, cover one side with paper, the other side with paper, and then the little flap with paper, you know, that opens up, and I just adhere down either side of the flap. So this is a paper bag, this is one complete paper bag right here. This is a full paper bag when it's laying out, so you don't even have to cut it at all. You just score it in the center, fold it in half, cover the flap and the page, and then glue down the side. And then I have on this page a little pull-out tag for photo and journaling, and it's all stitched, and I attached on a little bit of ribbon for an easy pull tab, and that just slips easily right back inside of there. And then on this page, I have a little journaling spot, so you could add some journaling, as well as the Prima flowers, a couple of the vintage ephemera from that paper collection, little tags, as well as some more Prima, and I added some white lace on here. And I'm going to add some large photo mats inside of here for the person who buys it. I mentioned that in my ad, but I did not have it in the photos, so that'll be added. And then on this page, so as you can see, it's completely separated, and right here it's completely together, and it's all the same paper going across. So if you can see on the front, it's the cherries, and on here it's as well as the cherries. So it's just going across the whole page. Then again, I added another stitched photo mat here, if you can see that, some more zigzag stitching. And I added a couple wraps of this cotton cording, and I added it on This side with a Prima Hydrangea, which I distressed, and a button and a couple more Prima flowers and another piece of the journaling, and it says Historic Route 66. And on this page, I added another stitched photo mat with some stitched ribbon from Stampin' Up. This is not from Stampin' Up, sorry. My other stitched ribbon is. And I added on this journey ticket, and everything slips underneath. I just hot glued the journey ticket onto the ribbon underneath, so it's just, you could slide your photos underneath. And then I added this piece on. And how I did that, you guys, was I opened it up, and inside of here, I just taped the ribbon on either side. So you don't even have to wrap it around to the other side. Really easy with a paper bag, because you could hide your stuff in the little folds. And I added on another kind of like just a little book plate, and a Prima flower with a Recollections rose and a handmade stick pin in there. On this page, I added on a photo mat with some stitching. You could probably see that stitching a little bit better. And then some of my favorite cotton lace and that I got from Nancy. And then this little tag that came in the collection, and then a couple flowers. Again, on this page, a little pull-out tag with some vintage ladies on it. And it's all stitched and everything. And then this page has a little pocket for ephemera or whatever you want to put in there. And then a Prima flower and one of my handmade lamp work beads that I attached on to a stick pin, and I added on a little pearl. And then I added on some of the pearl strand around the edges. On the next page, I created another stitched photo mat, and I attached on another one of the little tags, and your photo slips underneath there. And then it's attached up to the top, and again inside of the page there. And a couple Prima flowers and some jute, or kind of like a roping I got from Nancy. I love that, Nancy. Really fun to work with. And then on this page, I added another photo mat. And this little vintage ladies ticket is from the collection, and I just slipped it under a Tim Holtz paperclip, or the paper fastener. I think that's a paperclip. And I added on some vintage lace and a velvet flower I got from Diane, which I inked. Thanks so much, Diane. And then I added on a Prima flower and a couple buttons. And again, more of the photo mats are going to go inside of these pockets. And then a large die cut and two of the Prima flowers, and I love this cloth die cut. And then I added some of that satiny, silky ribbon across the edge, and I wrinkled it. What I did was I wet it. I kind of crinkled it and pressed it with a iron, so it kind of gave it this kind of crinkled, distressed look, which I really like. And then I stitched around the edges, added on yet another Prima flower, and it kind of has this waffle texture. It's really nice. And then this houndstooth background, which I love. It's so cool. I love houndstooth. I wish I could paint my wall houndstooth. That would be so unique. And then a little vintage lady tag and some gold Prima ribbon with the glitter on it. And then another ephemera ticket from the collection and a velvet flower from my Diane. I love those, Diane. They're so much fun to work with. And then a Prima flower, a Prima bling, and a couple lines of the accordion. Again, it's hidden behind the paper. And the very back has a little journaling spot for you to add on the family's last name or the family's name and the date. And maybe even a couple other things like the names of the people that are in it or whatever you'd like to do. So that is the Family Traditions mini album, you guys. And you can find this mini album on my eBay account, which is in the link in the description below, as well as you could find it on my website at scrappyhappiness.com. The link is as well as in the description below. And it'll be the Vintage Family Traditions mini album post, and it'll have a link directly to my eBay, as well as the video. So thanks so much for watching, guys, and have an awesome day. Bye, everyone.